Let me show you two different flamethrowers, and you tell me what the difference is. Don't actually tell me. This is a video. I can't hear you. But if you had trouble telling the difference, then I wouldn't fault you. On the left, we have a festive flamethrower, and on the right, we have a festivized flamethrower. Visually, they are almost near identical, almost to the point that most won't be able to tell in-game. A festive flamethrower has a little black battery box and a thin gray wire, while the festivized flamethrower has an open green battery box with visible batteries and a green wire to match. Also, one is $2 and the other one is $28. Yeah, let's get into it. So what's the deal with festives and why does it matter so much? My name is Everfrost, and you could probably tell from my profile that I kind of have a thing for festive weapons. I love all things holiday and festive, so me being able to have twinkly lights on my weapons at Rampage, TF2, is perfect for me. So I want to make this video to help people learn the difference and maybe help people appreciate the original TF2 festive weapons. But let's take a quick look at the history of festive weapons in Team Fortress 2. In December 15 of 2011, Valve released the Australian Christmas update for TF2, adding the first Naughty Winter crate that could be unboxed with a Naughty Winter key to receive one of the first set of festive weapons. The original set included the Scattergun, Bat, Rocket Launcher, Flamethrower, Sticky Bomb Launcher, Minigun, Medigun, Sniper Rifle, and Knife. The following year, we received the Holy Mackerel, Buff Banner, Extinguisher, Grenade Launcher, Sandwich, Frontier Justice, Ubersaw, Huntsman, and Ambassador. 2013 saw the release of the Forces of Nature, Black Box, Flare Gun, Islander, Gloves of Running Urgently, Wrangler, Crusader's Crossbow, Karate, and Sapper. Finally, in 2014, we had our final release with the Bonk Atomic Punch, the Shotgun, Backburner, Tarzan Charge, Bone Saw, SMG, and Revolver. The following year, in 2015, we would see the Tough Break update during the Smithmas time, with no new winter crates to open this year, and instead having the 2015 festive gift boxes that dropped festivizers, a new item that brought festivized items into the mix. Players could use these festivizers to turn any weapon skin from the Gunmetal or Tough Break into a festivized version, adding blinking lights in the same vein as the original festive weapons. As Valve added war paints to TF2, these would also become compatible with festivizers. In 2016, Valve added more weapons that could be festivized, along with the Sandman, Shovel, Fire Axe, Scottish Resistance, Natasha, Jag, Chris Krieg, Quick Fix, Kirkery, Spicicle, and the Pistol. In 2017, you would see the end of festivized weapons, adding Ubersaw, Dragon's Fury, Amputator, Airstrike, Backscratcher, Scotsman, Skullcutter, Bizarre Bargain, Black Box, Claydamore, Crusader's Crossbow, The Greaser, Loose Cannon, Persian Persuader, Detonator, Breastpiece, Holy Macro, Lock and Load, Power Jack, Iron Bomber, Berserk Shooting, Distant Player, Any Action, Family Business, A Shot Hand, Scorch Shot, Short Stop, Soda Popper, Rescue Ranger, Tommy Slot, Panic Attack, and Winger. Now you may be confused, why did Valve switch to festivizers instead of just adding more festive weapons? Well, I believe it came down to two main reasons. One, Valve made the switch to war paints since the game was full of strangers at this point and wanted to incentivize people to spend more money on weapons again. For example, a strange rocket launcher only goes for a dollar and some change, but a good war paint can go into the double digits. Making these war paints compatible with festivizers just made them more exciting and sought after. Two, Valve had already added festive weapons for most of the popular weapons in TF2. All stock primaries had a festive version, and most classes already had a full festive loadout. You can try to be that guy in the comments that says he would totally use the festive pumps in every match, but most people would only use niche weapons once in a blue moon, and it would just lead to backpack warmers and flood the market. Now, there are good and bad reasons for the inclusion of festivizers. Festivizers open up a lot of room for creativity and expression. If you had a favorite weapon skin, you could just slap some lights on it and bam, festive time. And with new festivizers refreshing the market every Smithmas, with crate unboxings, there was never any major shortage, evening them to about $2 a pop, meaning it was never a big investment to add lights to a weapon. This also allowed people to have even more festive weapons and increase their collections. Sadly, it wasn't without its drawbacks. While the original festive weapons might be more expensive than festivizers, this is nothing compared to what they used to be. Festivizers destroyed the value of original festives. An original festive rocket launcher was worth over $100 in its prime, but with the release of festivizers, it lost more than half of its value. This is because most players do not care for the slight differences and will take the cheaper option. Most Festives suffered this loss in value, which made them even less wanted. In January 2018, Valve edited the items made with Festivizers to say Festivize instead of Festive to help separate them from the originals. This, alongside the original weapon saying the word Limited in yellow text and having a different facing backpack icon, are the key things to look for when making sure a weapon is a genuine OG, so be careful when trading for them. Personally, I was a huge fan of the original Festives, as sometimes they had new model features like the Flare's Candy Cane or the Jurati being in a bottle. This felt like it had much more love and effort put into it than just copy and pasting lights onto a weapon. But this is a remnant from a better time. Anyways, I hope you liked this video and maybe it made you learn something new. If you would like to see more videos like this, please make sure to subscribe and like the video. It really makes my day. Also, you can find me over on Twitch where we have a fun community to hang out with. I hope you have a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. And until the next one, stay frosty.